Hello, this is the luckiest maths teacher in the world. Thank you so much for tuning into this video in which we review what was covered in week six. So week six was all about geometric series. That is adding up the terms of a geometric sequence. And this is the formula you need to know here. So let's use it to find the sum of the first 20 terms of this sequence. So S20, sum of the first 20 terms is equal to A, first term, times r to the power of n. Now, if you don't know r, take any term and divide the previous term. Here, r is negative 0.5. Whenever we substitute a negative, always use brackets. So a, r to the power of n minus 1, all divided by r minus 1. Now, if we put that in our calculator, we get approximately 682.666, okay? So we don't get a whole number here because these terms eventually are going to become decimals. All right, let's do this question. How many terms of this sequence must be added for the sum to exceed 1 million? So because we're talking a sum, we're going to use this formula here. Because we're asking how many terms, we're actually going to be solving for n. So in this case, the sum is going to be a. Now r is 3, so 3 to the power of n minus 1 over 3 minus 1. What I want is that to exceed 1 million. So I can just simplify this nice and easily. The 2 on top and 3 minus 1 is 2 on the bottom cancel out. So this is just an exponential equation. I have 3 to the power of n minus 1 is greater than a million. So what I'm going to do is add 1 to both sides. So remember, the way we solve exponential equations, I can either graph them on the graphics calculator or use logs. So if I'm using logs, I'll get n is greater than log of 1,000,001 over log 3. Now, the answer I get isn't a whole number. If I do log of 1,000,001 over log of 3 on my calculator, I get about 12.57. So what that means is n has to be greater than that. N has to be at least 13. So I need 13 terms. We always round decimals up. So 12 terms would give me a sum that's a little less than a million. 13 terms, if I sum them, would give me something over 1 million. All right, let's now look at limiting sums. So when we're talking about limiting sums, we're talking about adding infinitely many terms in a geometric series. So let's look at these two examples to illustrate what we're talking about. Now in this first one here, r equals 3. Each subsequent term is getting larger and larger. So if I keep on adding terms to this series, then the sum's just going to get larger and larger. There's no limit to how big it can become. So this sum will just equal infinity. But what about this one here? Here r is a third, and what is happening is each term is getting smaller and smaller. As we go on, each term will get closer and closer to zero, so adding these terms won't really do much to the sum. It turns out if I keep adding terms forever, if I add infinitely many terms of this series, the sum will actually converge. It will reach a limit. So this one here is not convergent, this one here is convergent. So how can we tell by just looking at a geometric series whether or not it will converge? Well, there's a very simple rule. We just have to look at r. If r is between negative 1 and 1, the series will converge. Because if r is between negative 1 and 1, it means the terms are getting smaller and smaller. They're getting closer to 0. If r is more than 1 or less than minus 1, like this one here, the series will diverge because the terms will get further and further away from 0. So if I have a convergent sequence, how do I calculate the limiting sum? Well, it's a very simple formula here. So this sum will just converge to a, first term, over 1 minus r, which is equal to 4.5. So if I keep adding more and more terms to this sum, it will get closer and closer and closer to, but never fully reach 4.5. All right, let's try this example here. So what's the value of x if x plus x squared plus x cubed and so on equals 9? So here we have an infinite geometric series. Infinitely many terms. It's a GP with A and R both equal to X. The first term's X, the common ratio is also X. Now this will converge to 9 if and only if R is between minus 1 and 1. So we should get a value for X between minus 1 and 1, or we've done something wrong. So how do I find out what that is? Well, I'm just going to use this formula here. So I have A over 1 minus R is equal to 9. So how do I solve this equation? I'm just going to times each side by the denominator of the fraction, then expand the brackets. So what we do here is add 9x to both sides. Then we get 10x equals 9, and x just equals 9 over 10, or 0.9. And we know we've done something right because we got x, the common ratio between minus 1 and 1. All right, let's now look at using limiting sums in recurring decimals. So we're now going to write 0.24 recurring as a fraction. So the dot above the 2 and the 4 means both digits are repeated forever. So it goes on like this. How can we possibly write this as a fraction? Well, it turns out this can be written as two limiting GPs added together. See, what we have here is the 2 is in the tenths column, the 4 is in the hundredths, the 2 is in the thousandths, and so on. So we can write it like this. So we're now going to group all the 2s together and all the 4s together. So it turns out this here is a limiting geometric series, and so too is this one here. So this one here is a geometric sequence. A is 2 over 10, and the common ratio is 1 over 100. So infinitely many terms of this will converge to A over 1 minus R. So it has a limiting GP because R, the common ratio, is between minus 1 and 1. So similarly, these 4s, they all form a limiting GP. It will converge to A over 1 minus R. Again, R is 1 over 100, so it has a limiting GP because R is between minus 1 and 1. So making this easier to work with, this is just 2 over 10. Over 99 over 100, and then this is just 4 over 100 divided by 99 over 100. So what we actually get is it's 20 over 99 plus 4 over 99, which is equal to 24 over 99, and you can simplify that to 8 over 33. So 0.24 recurring is 8 over 33. We figured it out using sum of limiting GP by putting all the 2s together to form one limiting GP and all the 4s together to form another limiting GP. All right, thank you so much for tuning into this video. This has been the luckiest maths teacher in the world. Have a great day.